So on a day when you've seen the S&P 500 circuit breakers kick in for a second time this week, downside on the equity has been pretty bad, Dow over 2,000 points. You might expect to see in the metals quadrant gold to rally, but we're down again on gold. As a matter of fact, we were down 5% on the lows in the April futures contract from yesterday's settle to today's lows. Recovered a little bit more than 1.5% into that close, but still finished over 3.33% lower. And that is the fourth consecutive day lower for the precious metal, which again kind of belies its flight to safety quality. But you're looking at a situation where investors are raising cash. When you have moves like this, you get quite a few margin calls in the stock world, in the futures world. Everywhere there's margin possibility, you get these dramatic volatile moves, you get margin calls. And we saw yesterday that investors were actually selling treasuries to fulfill some of that stuff. Today, they're continuing to sell gold because when you get to a point where everything seems like it's falling just to zero, cash is all that people want, so they get out of a lot of things. They're doing that with gold as well. And then lastly, the dollar rally that we're seeing, you got a strong dollar rally today, which is mostly about the rally versus what's happening with the other currencies. For example, the euro got hit pretty bad on disappointment for the ECB stimulus package, didn't include rate cuts. The dollar rally is also hurting gold as well. Dollar got above 97 today, around 97.47 on the dollar index, actually spiked above 98 and then came back a little bit lower as well as gold came off the bottoms of its sell-off.